Okay, we're back. Slow motion. Finally figured out how to get through there without dying. Hey, it works. First time I tried that.
Alf. The old city is close.
Lara, we're on the mountain above the glacier.
Can you see Trinity?
Yes. They're beginning their operation.
I'm entering the old city now. Listen, Sophia. Don't attack them too soon.
We'll give it some time. I'll contact you again soon.
I thought I had died. Grew weak, even as I saw the Prophet's people camped on the ridge of a strange green valley. One foot after the other, sword in hand, I trudged on. I meant to charge, battle cry on my chapped lips, when consciousness fled and I collapsed into the arms of heretics. They know who I am. They have been expecting Trinity. They do not have much, but they fed me. Kept me warm until I could walk again. The Prophet told me I could leave whenever I desire, but they have taken my blades. Even armed, I do not know that I could kill this man. I have failed the Order. I have failed myself. But I live.
Deathless ones.
Thank you.
Nobody look left. Chap loop.
I leave these notes for whoever should follow in my footsteps. My wounds are worse than I believed. They will not heal. Tonight I will make one last attempt to escape this frozen tomb, but I doubt I have the strength. The divine source is here, at the peak of the tallest tower, but it is beyond my reach. With the source at his disposal, the prophet's deathless ones are unstoppable. An army of wraiths and devils that can never die. A mockery of all God's creation. They are no longer human, and they will break any army that stands in their way. With every death and rebirth, they learn. They adapt. Should Trinity someday find a way to seize it for ourselves, I fear that we will do no better. Perhaps it would be best if it were to remain lost forever.
Wait for us! What? There you go. Ah! Dodge! Oh, fuck! Jump scare. Oh, I see you. Thank you, mother. Just thank your mother.
Just go, just go.
Akina, shut off the beam!
Trinity has twice before sent great men seeking the Prophet's path, and twice before they have vanished. He carried the divine source out of the Empire, but it was not his to take. That blasphemy taints everything while his descendants still live. So Trinity must try again. I have done ungodly things, committed terrible sins against the innocent, just to reach this place. To retrieve the divine source. I know God will forgive for what I do for the greater good. Now the end is in sight. I need only survive this final battle, and Trinity's work will be done.
General, we observe something strange in the night. We are camped above the city of Gitesh as the city prepares for invasion. They still believe the attack will expect your charge from the paths on the far side of the valley. But I must tell you, on the tower at the heart of the city, something unnatural awaits us. We watched hundreds of armored soldiers ascend its heights, and then a light cracked the sky. There was a sound that froze my blood. A roaring like an army of hungry ghosts. Then the men descended again. I do not know what they keep atop that tower. We thought it a treasure, but it appears to be something else entirely.
This is, particularly odd. Has elements of Scythian design, but it looks like a... No, not possible.
ice any minute.
Do you think you can stop them?
The best we can do is buy you some time. I'll see you on the other side.
Be no pardon for my sins. I have drenched my hands in blood in pursuit of the Prophet, and now there is nothing left. As the attack became a siege, the Prophet's people did the unthinkable. They turned their weapons against the glaciers and buried their own city. Mongol and the Prophet's people alike were crushed in the ice. The Khan and his warrior horde are dead. The people of Katesh are broken and scattered. I alone survive in the frozen heart of the city, and my only companions are the deathless army of the Prophet. Their eyes aflame with unholy light. Even now, they hunt the ruins for survivors.
Underestimated them, huh? Well, I can see why. So far, they've been kind of easy.
I don't know what I expected an immortal being to be like, but Jacob seems so human. The things he must have seen over the years, all that experience and knowledge, it's difficult to fathom. And yet, he lied to his own people for generations, all for the sake of this secret. What wonders will be unlocked with the Divine Source? Will humans finally understand the true nature of the soul? Or will it unlock some extraordinary new scientific discovery? One thing is certain. It's too important to allow Trinity to control.
Peace. Just kill him. Easy. Now how do I get to that?
Valentinus, the timekeeper.
After the city was built, the first generation of followers stared out upon it. One among them, a man named Valentinus, has spent his whole life devoted to the study of time and its passage. The prophet sought him out in the crowd and asked him what he thought of the city. Valentinus said he felt it was a blessed place, that time would move slowly there, and that Gatesh would last for generations untold. The prophet smiled, for he knew that he had made a home where his people might be safe.
At last, I killed one of the deathless soldiers. As if he knew the sound of my bowstring. He was strong, but I am clever and I have faith. My arrows pierced his flesh, but he fought on until I placed a shot between his eyes. Even then, he managed to wound me before I caved in his skull. His body caught fire and fell into ash before my eyes. It has been hours since he died, but his ashes still smolder, hissing and popping in the darkness. I do not believe this is his end. The source has a great and terrible sway over those it touches. I must know what happens next.
Mongolian grammar is tricky, but it reads like directions.
That worked. Oh shit. Poison works on these guys pretty well. Do I want to go over there? Well, this is interesting though. Run, piggy. Where'd you go? Whoa. What's this? Oh. Did you run out of flares? There it is.
A blue glass vase. Still in excellent condition. Not many of these survived, for obvious reasons. Iron pendant. Soldiers in the Empire would sometimes tie them to their belts. things under the water.
Gas, gas, gas.
I'll need to provide the spark.
Oops, wrong button. Back, shit, run.
Demonic possession. They were performing exorcisms.
Thank you.
deep below the holy ground of our city, we have found the source of the corruption. One of Hell's winding tunnels snakes up and vomits forth a miasma of evil. There is no pattern to the demon's depredations, but his mark is plain. Men driven to wicked words and acts, as God's grace is driven from them. We take them here to the mouth of Hell itself to drive out the demons. We do not always succeed. Often the poor wretches are too far gone, and they die when we drive the beasts out of them. It is heartbreaking to lose good people, but we must stand against the devil in all his forms.
Set it up somehow. At least get rid of the bodies. But what am I gonna do with that? Cut it. What the hell?
No telling how many people died here. They believe this cavern was a gate to hell.
My mind is clear today. It was not so yesterday, and it will not be again. They say the devil is inside me. They say I am possessed. I have seen the beast in my heart, and it is only me, only my broken mind. But the priests will not listen. I cannot blame them. Some days they appear to me as apparitions of manifest pain and hatred. So clouded are my eyes. I spit and yowl, for I am mad. But I know there is no evil in my heart. Only sickness that no man can cure.
Self-diagnosed. What does this do? What else can we do? Oh, what was that? How do we get that off?
Hmm.
This doesn't look like a lot of options around here. Oh, the water goes down. Oh, I see. Don't have much time then. Don't have much time, so I'm taking time. Oh, wrong button. Oh, there you go.
Yes, got it.
Oop. Get out of that poison. Okay, now we can lift this up. For whatever reason.
All right, that should be high enough.
And then there's gotta be something to do with turning this thing, right? Set them on fire for some reason. And ready? No. Projectile. Using them as a projectile. Sorry to desecrate your dead body like that.
A codex. Oh my god, this is the formula for Greek fire.
Yeah. Well. Hi guys. Oh, that's a good stopping point.